Greetings world. We are Anonymous. Today marks the 2-year anniversary of the death of one of our brothers. His name was John Lang, of Fresno, California. John ultimately died as the result of multiple stab wounds, concurrent with his house being set on fire. The coroner's report citing the official cause of death as carbon monoxide poisoning via smoke inhalation. The media and official sheriff run office would have you believe this was a suicide. However, the physical wounds on his upper back say otherwise. John predicted he would be murdered. Days before he died, he posted a message on social media saying that if he would die in the days to follow, the Fresno Police Department would be responsible. John was not an ordinary person. He was harshly disliked by the local police, a force known for its previous gross misconduct, for his activism against their corruption. He had stumbled across an illegal police ticketing scam being conducted by several Fresno police employees. After reporting this scam to the authorities, John himself became the victim of harassment and he was stalked by people clearly working for law enforcement. John Lang had no criminal record and was an upstanding small business owner. So there was no reason to harass or stalk him, except for the fact he was exposing corruption. He back down from his claims of a police scam and started documenting the harassment he faced. For over a year, John had posted videos from his security camera systems of suspicious activity outside his house. These videos show marked police cars sitting outside, random and marked vans with government plates driving by, and even your cliché white service vans showing up in the neighborhood. Perhaps the most shocking video of all shows a van pulling up across the street from his house. Someone opens the sliding door and there is a man with what appears to be some sort of camera. The claim is that it was a thermal imaging camera and the police were checking to see if John was home. In case it was just a normal camera, it still seems highly suspicious and should terrify anyone who watches it. This event fueled his suspicion that something was seriously wrong. There have been claims by some that John Lang was simply paranoid, on drugs, or even suffered from schizophrenia. However, the toxicology report has proven that he was clean. Next to that, there is a great deal of evidence that shows that the temporal lobe structures in schizophrenic patients are smaller. Some studies have found the hippocampus and amygdala to be reduced in volume. But this was not the case with John Lang. His brain was perfectly normal. So why did the Fresno police, or the media, not address the claims John made? Especially since those claims are so closely connected to his death. A fact that becomes evident when we look at his posts on social media. Like most police departments, the Fresno Police Department receives federal funding. The United States Department of Justice is charged with investigating any police department that is reported by citizens for corruption. In a normal situation, this is the proper avenue for citizens to fight police corruption. And the Department of Justice under the Obama administration failed with its duty towards John Lang. President Donald Trump was asked to direct the Department of Justice to take another look at this case. The justification even exists for the Fresno Police Department to be charged under the RICO statutes. But so far, 2 years later, we have seen no results. This case not only deserves to be solved, but it needs to, for the justice of John Lang and all of us. And because no one is doing this, we will do it ourselves. It is the common people's duty to police the police. We are John Lang. Operation Fresno 2018 commenced. We are Anonymous. We are the voice of the voiceless. We are the eyes of the blind. We are Legion. We do not forgive. We do not forget. Expect us.